the summer I was doing full stack development at POC Media. So a little background about POC. POC is a music company out of King of Prussia, and they're pretty small. They run it out of their house, but a lot of what they do is like music marketing and stuff like that. So I'll read a little thing from the website. POC Media connects the dots between brands and the entertainment industry, working with major record labels, major film studios, sports organizations with their respective teams and broadcast outlets, several Fortune 500 companies, and numerous global brands. POC Media designs, develops, produces, and implements innovative marketing strategies that generate measurable results. So what that means and what they do is kind of in order of importance and how much they do it. So music licensing, so like creating licenses for artists so that they can get noticed for their music and they can have copyrights for it, things like that. And music placement, which is kind of like, a lot of what they do is they work between artists and music outlets, so like stadiums and television and movies and stuff like that. So like when you see like a highlight reel from a sports something, like when they're like dunking like right to the music, that's what they do. They sell that music to those companies so that they have something to use. And then music marketing and advertising. So what they, a lot of what they do is they try and generate measurable results for artists so that you can see how well the artist is doing. So like what they do is like they'll market the artist so that they can get their YouTube views up, their Shazams up, and Spotify plays and things like that. So just generally getting artists out there and getting them known. And then concert setup. So they do a lot of like NASCAR races, and I think Taylor Swift had like a concert at a Walmart or something, and they set that up. So they do a lot of different concerts and things like that. And this is their stage that they have. It's pretty massive, pretty bad picture. And then video production and editing. So like music documentaries and music videos and stuff. They produce and edit those videos and do things like that with artists. And then other music-related jobs. So they're kind of like the handyman of the music industry. So I know one time while I was working there, they, one of the stadiums needed like to keep track of the songs that they were playing. So POC created like a Raspberry Pi that was like constantly Shazamming, kind of like Shazamming songs while they were printing. And then when they found a match, they'd send it back to our server and they would lock it and keep track of everything for everybody. So what I did at POC, since it's a small company, there's only the one developer and then there's me that was working there in the summer, so they created like this long list of things that they needed done that they had priorities for, hadn't gotten time to get to. So the main thing that I did the whole summer was fan outreach, which was this idea of like this portal that they had created, and they wanted to give fans the ability to like move the numbers for like YouTube views and Shazam plays and things like that. So if so the idea of the portal was that they would play Shazam song, or they would Shazam song, or like play a song on Spotify, or like an artist on Facebook or something, they would get points for it. And at the end of the day, when they had so many points, they could redeem it for like a Starbucks gift card for like coffee, or you know, Amazon gift card, something like that. And then another large part of what I did was what they call gratis music, which gratis is an idea that they came up with where they'll license a song for free for the stadium so that that artist can get exposure, and they'll obviously do it for free so the sports teams are more inclined to use their work. And the way that they were doing it before was they would reach out to artists and say, hey, I hear you're an artist, you know, we've seen you on the radio and stuff like that, let us license your music and promote you. But they would email them, they would email us back, and it was like this whole long process of like us not reading our emails, them not reading our emails, so by the time they finally cleared an artist, it was like 3 weeks or so. So they wanted me to create this music portal where the, we would reach out to the artists and the artists would just like log into the portal, upload their music, and then when we had time, we would just go through it all, and if we liked an artist, we'd reach out to them and say, hey, you know, we want to promote you. And then towards the end, I worked on this, what they wanted was a newsletter. So like it was just generated based on like the songs that they had hot for the week. And then they would send that out to like stadiums and things like that so they can know that we're, what we're up to, they can see what we're doing. And then pre-concert setup truck days, which were pretty much the worst part of the job, but since they were setting up concerts and it was this pretty small company, there was like 10 of us or so, they would hire people to work to set up, like move heavy equipment into the trucks. And since I'm a young, strong guy, they were like, hey, you know, you want to set up these trucks for us. So we would spend all day like slaving away in the hot sun, like moving these really heavy speakers. But luckily I didn't have to do a lot of that. So since POC was a pretty small company, there was a couple perks. So working for a small company, I got to do a lot of different things. Like I was designing systems, creating interfaces, working on the server side, handling data, just basically a lot of different stuff. Whatever they wanted me to do, I was able to do. As opposed to where if I was like working at a large company, I would have been like running coffee or working on like upgrading spreadsheets. It would have been more focused. And immediately I was recognized for like doing good work. So like if I did a good job, they would notice. But on the inverse of that, like if I was doing a bad job, they would also notice. It was like kind of a kick in the butt. It's like I need to keep doing good work or else they're gonna notice. And one of my favorite parts was Henry the dog. So since they were running it out of their house, they had this pet dog, and every now and then he would like come into the office area and like throw me his ball, and I'd like stop and play with him for like 10 minutes. So overall, it was a pretty good experience. So, any questions?
Let's give Mitchell a round of applause.